2013 on the Newbie Farm. Alright, so last time we left off with a problem with our combine. Because I wanted to use a modded combine, not the standard combines. So I tried to mod the combine myself. It partially worked. So here's what I had to do. Same combine, just changed the head. What was happening was the head wasn't cutting, but the combine recognized the fruit. So I sold the class head that came with it, and I got a standard header from this is the game, I guess. So in this case, it's a bit shorter. It's 7.2 meters instead of 7.5 meters, so 0.3 meters. Not terrible, but slightly annoying, but whatever. At least it's functioning now, and I have a cool-looking combine, at least. So, as you can see, my combine is currently harvesting hemp. And he already harvested the spring wheat. So, in this particular combine, because we're taking a bigger cut out of the fruit, or hemp in this case, we upgraded our trailer as well. And I was trying to use course play with my other tractor, the International Harvester, and it didn't function properly for whatever reason. I don't know why. So I switched tractors up and it worked fine, so I'll have to see if anybody else is having a similar problem with them or not. Might just be that particular combine. Anyways, so what we're going to do this episode is we're going to harvest our hemp and then our oats. And we're also going to do some planting. So in this case, he finished planting rye already. Gotta wait till he's heated up first. So, we're planting rye. I thought maybe when I'd have to reset the tractor to make it work, but with the course play, I mean, but it, nope, didn't work. So I had to put my dualies back on. So we can do millet, green wheat, hemp, oats, rye. That's it on this tractor. Let's do some millet, because we haven't done much millet yet. I would need a different... I would need a different planter or seeder for me to get to try and do the other fruits. So the original planter we start off with is the... Well, on this particular map at least. You start off with... Which one is it? It's the Hassia, I think it's called. This time... Here we are. We start off with this. And you can plant all... I think you plant everything. So I can't plant sunflowers with this or corn. I think there's one other thing I can't plant. Yeah, anyways. So I can't plant sunflowers. And sunflowers are the most profitable plant in the game. So what that would mean is I would also need to get a different header, and the new header is about 40,000, so it's a bit on the pricey side. So let's just double check to see how much that header costs. I think it's 40,000. Yeah, 46,000 actually. Yes. 46,000, and does 7.2 meters. So, that'd be a little bit of saving if I want to try and do sunflowers. But what I could do is do a rotation of sunflowers, canola, and something quicker than that. Because sunflowers, if canola takes as long as, well, I know how long canola takes. And if sunflowers take longer, that's going to be a long wait. So the idea is to try and rotate around. Oats wasn't too bad, hemp wasn't too bad actually, and neither was the spring wheat. All about average, so nothing too crazy there. So what I could do is, so corn, sugar beets, potatoes, oops, didn't want to do that. All right, there we go. So millet's probably quick to grow as well. Hay straw, green wheat, sorghum. We haven't done, we can do sorghum. I think we did, I may have done sorghum when I was off camera. I can't remember. But I think sorghum actually needs a corn header as well. So you can actually use sorghum as a silage alternative, so keep that in mind. Yes. Also, what I need to do is I need to sell some of the stuff. Let's just see if anything's coming as a... Wheat's coming up, oats coming up, and hemp's coming up. Oh, sweet. So we harvest this oat, and we're able to sell that for a better deal, a better price, and also for the hemp as well, so that'll be good. That'll give us lots of extra money. Probably not, but let's hope it does, right? Alright, so, got my... Gonna put him back in a group, so I had to reset him to see if that would work for horseplay. So he's got his dualies on, like I said before, to reduce compaction, and he's planting millet at the moment. So, we're gonna do some harvesting this episode, do some planting at the same time, and we'll probably do a little bit of spraying manure as well. This is where having a third tractor would come into play, but for now we'll stick with our two. I could always get another one, but this works for us now. So yeah, we had to change the header up to this header, so that's unfortunate, but glad it works regardless. We lost 0.3 meters, but whatever, I guess. I looked into it a little bit, but I didn't feel like spending a lot of time trying to figure out how to get the header to work properly, so I just use this one instead, and this is a quick fix as opposed to spending a lot of time trying to fix that header. If you know any good multi-fruit harvesters, like let's say the class Lexion 550, like this one right here, this same model that looks good, because I've seen a lot of harvesters that don't look so hot. This one at least looks good. If you know any, let me know in the comments. That'd be fantastic, because I like good looking combines. This one's one of my favorites, and the Class 770 TT TerraTrack is my other favorite, basically. And bigger farms, the other one, and smaller farms, this one. So, those are my choices, basically. I found an okay John Deere one, but it's not amazing. So, let's finish up this hemp here. Now, hemp does sell for a decent amount. Let's just go here. Hemp, $163 a ton, or $254 a ton at the freight yard, or $305 at the mill. So pretty decent price. I just hope I'm not sure if it actually sells for that. Like I said before, I wasn't sure. We'll find out. It didn't seem like, if you remember last episode, we actually sold 3,500, I think it was hemp or something, and did not make that much money off of it. So I don't know if it's something to do with the game file or something. It just seemed like we didn't make very much money, but I might be wrong. I do have the more realistic mod on, and I don't know if that affects hemp or not, or the prices of hemp, but it could very well be the fact that that's what's happening here. Like I said before, these mods do look pretty nice. Definitely like the look of them. Anyways, back to our combine. So, we're just going to finish up combine today, and we'll do some seeding at the same time, and I'll probably spray manure off camera. If you really want to see me spray manure on camera, that's fine. Or liquid manure, I should say. I don't really do manure, solid manure, just because I don't like having to deal with the whole filling the trailer, basically. I don't find it as efficient as using liquid manure, especially if you use a front loader too, which, as you found out last episode, not a big front loader person when it comes to emptying stuff. Especially when I don't need to. As you can see, hemp is quite has a quite a high yield in comparison to some other things. It's like It's basically roughly what you'd get from a wheat, it seems like. And because I just modded this combine, as you can see, it looks like wheat in there. Which is fine, as long as it identifies as hemp and not wheat. That's cool by me. Finish this field up, perfect. Open up our auger there. And wait till he gets under. And perfect. Look at that. That's cool because it actually does look like that in real life when you're in the combine. That seat right there, that they call the training seat sometimes. I think it's called the training seat. So what happens is basically you learn how to use a combine there. Perfect. Gonna send this driver home. And then guess I was still a hired worker there. So we're gonna go get the oats and try and keep it a shorter episode maybe today. The last episode was an hour long, I think it was. When I looked at the end, I thought it was only like 40 minutes, but it turned out to be an hour. Little longer than I thought. Oh well. I'm sure you'll let me know whether you like a longer episode or a shorter episode. Either's fine for me for the most part. And I think next season I will probably do a try and do another multi-fruit, but if not, I'll probably do it on like normal or easy, just because I just spent a lot of time off screen doing things just so get to this point. Maybe it's just because the way I play, I don't like doing the whole biogas thing. That's probably part of it as well, but maybe it's just me. You also don't get on hard, you actually don't get very much money for biogas either. Okay, oats works too. Good. Looks like it was just the header then. And I can use this combine because this one combine looks way cooler than the other 7545. And I don't think the cameras actually work. Let's find out. So, where is it? I guess they kind of do. No, looks like they don't. In cab. I love it. I don't know if there's anything else I can actually play around with. No, that's it looks like. Yeah, apparently the default fruit color or the fruit it goes to is wheat if you don't actually identify what type of, I don't know. Basically, what it boils down to is if you don't identify what picture to use, it just goes straight to wheat, which is fine by me. Ideally, it would look a little prettier than wheat, but this works. This gets her done. Also, as you can see, I left some canola here by accident, but it also lets you know there's no withering on this map either, which is kind of nice, I guess. Gotta request my driver back. Jeez, he's taking his time. So far, I'm happy that this combine worked out in the right way in the end. Because like I said, I don't like using the other ones very much. This one is a really nice looking combine. Where did I get it from? I think I got it from FSUK, like all my mods basically. They have a really nice system for outlining good mods and bad mods basically, so that's why I tend to stick with them. I do find some mods on Mod Hoster, but they're not. I find the quality isn't as good as on FSUK, so. It's cool in real life. What they'll do is they'll put a camera right on the auger there, so then you can see. I think does it have it here? Yeah, it's stuck behind my animal HUD there. But as you can see, it just shows that. Like if you look right there, there's a little camera, and you can see where you're going, which see where. Where your trailer is basically, and what actually happens is the person in the overloader tractor over there, they'll have control over the camera so they can see whether their trailer is over the auger or not, which is pretty cool. Thought that was a pretty little nifty little thing, although that's a little bit more high end for some people, so not everybody has that, as I'm sure you're aware. So as you can see, oats produces quite a bit. So I think everything I did green wheat, I did hemp, and I did oats, and basically everything that I decided to grow has about the same sort of yield as wheat. But they're all pretty low value in comparison to canola or sunflowers. So after I finish this field, I'll definitely go and sell some stuff, because we are running low on money because I had to buy this header, because it was 40 grand for this header, but it allowed us to actually harvest, so that was good. But what else can we do? Can we do anything else while we're waiting for that to go through? Probably not. I don't have that many tractors at the moment, so can't do too many things at the same time. Let's just take a look up here. Wheat, barley, oats, corn, potatoes, sugar beets, grass, hemp. So that's a new one. Oats, soybeans, sorghum, wheat. Yeah. I think the only thing I can't grow right now is sorghum and sunflowers. I can't harvest them either, so that's not very helpful. I could buy the smaller cedar and use it to plant sunflower, but then I need the other header, so yeah, I don't know. We'll see. I do need some more grass again. One of the silly things I never understood, like, if you hire a worker, like this is like a hired guy right now, you see you take like leaves like an extra little bit off there. Even if you line them up properly, it never works out the way you want it to. Don't know why. I like to think he would just use a full width of his header, but apparently doesn't. Although it does allow him to catch that little end piece, mind you, but I still think it's a little silly. There we go. Halfway done. Nice. Look at that. Beautiful. Never harvested oats. Oats aren't something a lot of people grow around my area, so I don't know much about them. So, fortunately, I can't give you the lowdown on oats in real life. Can only tell you that in this game, they're not worth very much, and I'm pretty sure in real life, they're not worth a whole lot either. Canola can be, depending on the year. I know this year, soybeans spiked in terms of price. I think it was like $1,200 a ton, I think it was. And then it spiked at 1,300, and then it dropped again. So, commodities markets constantly changing. So let's try and line them up a bit better and see what happens. Maybe that'll help. We'll see. We'll see if that actually makes a difference or not. I don't think it will, but for the first pass, maybe it will, and after that, probably not. Let's lower this. Get her lined up there. There we go, hire a worker. I'm a terrible harvester. Like I said in a previous episode, I feel like sometimes I'm more of a manager just because the way it works around some farms, but I only have so many tractors in this particular game. So it makes it kind of funny to think of yourself in that particular manner, I guess, so. Awesome. Yeah, I don't know. Do I have anything I could sell maybe to make some more money? I don't think so. Nope. Everything I need, basically. Except for the dualies, I suppose, but they're not worth very much. Alright. The joys of having few tractors. I think I should plant this field as wheat because I need some wheat for my chickens again, because they are not at 110% productivity. But I should remind myself to do wheat on this particular field. or else I'll have no wheat for my chickens. And they won't like that. So yeah, it still doesn't use all of it. I don't understand. I don't know why. Anyhow. He's almost done. Just over halfway. Anyways, I think I will stop. Should I stop? Nah, let's go a little bit further. Let's go until we get this field fully harvested, and then we'll sell some things, and then we'll call it an episode. How about that? Alright, so he is almost full. 64%. This might fill him up just past that. What will he end up at? 60, 70, 80? Yeah, I guess the guy who modded this trailer, or all of them, just used the regulars, like basically what I did in the combine. As long as it works. I guess if you wanted to go fancy, you can go and change all the graphics too, but that's a lot of extra work, I'm sure. All right, let's go sell this right now, actually. And let's go sell it at. Oats. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. What's worth a lot? Is oats gonna come up on great demand? Yes, it will. So let's just wait, actually, then. My bad. Getting too anxious here. 6 hours? I can probably just speed up time for 6 hours. And then get a oats. Great demand. Apparently my hard worker over there, or my course play worker over there, is doing his going all over the place again. Oats, wheat, and hemp. How much do I have of each right now? I have 32,000 agreement. That's from that one field over there, field number 8, 32,000. Hemp 46,000 from the other field. And then where is oats? Green, earth fruits, nope. Oats. So oats is only gonna give me I don't know, 30,000 maybe or something. Okay, a bit more than 30. 35. Almost 40, I guess. Somewhere close to 40, at least, so. I'm actually going to speed up time now so that I get a great demand of oats. So I can go and sell it right away without you guys having to wait around for too long. I always thought the beacons look a little funny on this one. They don't spin or anything, but they look good, but they don't look like really amazing beacons, I guess. I don't know. If there's such a thing as amazing beacons. 4 hours until great demand. Well, it has another 10,000, so we'll get about 40,000 then. Good thing he's waiting on this side, or else our course play guy over there would probably get stuck in the wall. So this is good that he stopped here, although our dude's taking his time. I'm just gonna go make it a bit easier. Oh well, that's what happens when you stop it. Gonna have to try and get around him. Let's see how that goes. Probably not very well. Yeah. Yep, not too good. So what I'll do is, I will just leave that guy there, come over here, get this guy out of the way. I don't know how I managed to get up that so easily. I'm going to dump off these oats, and then I'm going to, I guess I could start from the other side, and just do it that way basically. And then I'll start him up, and then I'll let the course play guy do his thing. And then I can go sell some oats, because it's almost time for a great demand on oats. 2 hours. Get this guy started. 1 hour till oats. This is good. Perfect, hire a worker. Go back to my fence here. Just gonna drive behind combine, pick up everything, and then, my friends, it'll be great demand time. Woot. There we go. Slow down time because I'm pretty sure as your great demand progresses, the price you get decreases. I'm just gonna stop this now. The price you get decreases, which is no cool, not cool. It's just the way it goes. Looks like my other worker over there is slowly finishing. One downfall. There we go. Let him finish his line here and then get fully unloaded. Perfect. And let's go. Once this guy's unloaded, there we go. Let's go get the rest of the oats, or some of the more of the oats. And then we will. Hope there's nothing left. Yeah, good. And then we will go take it to. I'm gonna try somewhere else other than the mill. And of course, it's at the mill. Never mind. So let's see how much I get from this. So I'm gonna have a full trailer load, so that's 29,000 in this. So I should get a fair amount, but we'll see. Oats, sunflowers, green wheat, sorghum. I guess oats are up here. I always forget what they are. Right, oats, here we are. Let's fill up the trailer. Get out of the negative here. That's what happens when you buy things and you leave yourself low on cash. Perfect. All right, 29,000 liters of oat with a great demand. We should get a fair amount of money, right? Let's get an in cab here. So we should get a fair amount of money, but I don't know. Maybe 10,000 would be nice, but I don't think we're gonna get nearly that much. How much is it actually selling for? Oops, why do I keep doing that? Oats, 272. Okay. That's about the same price as what you get for wheat, although it seems like I get more for wheat than for oats. Let's check it out. So 272 is what the price we list off for oats, and we're gonna sell this and see what we get. Oh man. I'm not sure what to do next. I think I may have to change up this tractor. Don't know how, it doesn't say how many hours he's got on it, but I just don't like the way it looks very much, so that might be the next thing. Or actually, maybe I'll do, I think I'll do sunflowers first before I get too crazy here. Sunflowers and maybe sorghum as well, just so I can say I did it. And then progress from there. Right, let's see. Almost there. Just over the little hill, and then we shall be there. All right, let's see what we get. Do. All right. Here we go. Minus 562, 65. So not even 10,000, so 6,000. That's not terrible, I guess. But I feel like I get a lot more if I did it with wheat. I don't know why. It just seems that like that way. Must be my imagination. Anyways, I think I'm gonna leave the episode there for now, ladies and gents. I'm probably just gonna sell some more oats till I have no more oats left, And then I'm going to go from there, probably replant some fields, fertilize some fields, and that'll be it probably. And then we'll see what happens next. Anyways, my name's Ian Robson. I'll talk to you guys later, and have yourselves a good night.